Obesity is widely regarded as pandemic and has potentially disastrous consequences for human health, including metabolic syndrome, type 2 diabetes, hypertension, hyperlipidemia, leading to stroke and heart attack, liver fat accumulation, gallstones, colorectal cancer, sleep apnea, osteoarthritis, varicose veins, increased peripheral steroid interconversion in adipose tissue, which leads to polycystic ovary syndrome, infertility, breast and uterine cancer, psychological morbidity, low self-esteem, depression, skin infections and other conditions. One supplementary explanation for the epidemic of obesity might be food addiction and binge eating disorder, characterized by the compulsive consumption of high amounts of sugary and fatty foods. Compulsive overeaters tend to show brain changes similar to those of drug addicts. The research found that individuals who had binge eating disorder were more likely to have experienced physical or sexual abuse, stress, and body criticism. Emotional eating, also known as stress eating, is defined as eating to cope with negative emotions. Fat and sugar-filled foods trigger dopamine and opioid releases, which may contribute to people's stress-induced cravings for those foods. Other causes of obesity can include mutations in the leptin gene, which leads to decreased sensitivity to leptin, hormone inhibiting hunger, genetic conditions, Prader-Willi syndrome, hormonal diseases, Cushing syndrome, hypothyroidism, steroids, oral contraceptives, antipsychotics. The indicator of obesity is the body mass index, which is defined as the body mass divided by the square of the body height. When this value exceeds 30, the person is considered obese. The options for treatment of obesity are low-calorie diet, increased exercise at least 30 minutes 5 times per week, and education about healthy living. In meta-analysis, low-fat, low-calorie, low-carbohydrate, and high-protein diets all produce a mean 2-4 kg loss over 3-6 months. However, the majority of dieters regain weight over the long term. Therefore, in addition to dieting and exercise, cognitive behavioral therapy is effective and acts on the reasons that induce a person to overeat and aims to develop self-control and change attitude towards food. Do not think about it. Do not be obsessed about it. The patient learns to evaluate the harmful effects of obesity and the positive effects of weight loss, stops self-pity and all kinds of self-justification, tries to learn not to succumb to primitive impulses and not to give oneself instant pleasure and reward, but to postpone it. The ultimate goal should be a healthy, balanced diet and maintaining a healthy weight, not just losing a certain number of pounds. Dialectical behavioral therapy also has proven itself in the treatment of eating disorders. It focuses on the regulation of negative emotions, distress tolerance, and mindfulness. Being mindful of what or how much the patient is consuming, and approaching cravings with a non-judgmental inquisitiveness. If an individual is faced with strong negative emotions, they may choose to avoid the situation by distracting themselves through overeating. The effective way to limit emotional avoidance is to confront the issue through problem solving and recognizing, tolerating, and expressing own emotions. A huge investment has been made by the pharmaceutical industry in finding drugs for obesity. The two drugs licensed in the UK and also by the US FDA are orlistat and sibutramine. Orlistat acts by inhibiting lipase in the gut and reduces absorption of fat. Sibutramine acts within the central nervous system to reduce appetite. These drugs should not be prescribed to patients with a body mass index lower than 30 and should be considered only once dietary, exercise, and behavioral approaches have been ineffective. Central nervous system stimulant lisdexamfetamine and antidepressant fluoxetine are used in the treatment of binge eating disorder and bulimia nervosa. Dietary supplements, though widely used, are not considered a healthy and effective option for weight loss. Bariatric surgery to reduce the size of the stomach is by far the most effective long-term treatment for obesity and has been associated with reduced mortality. But it is only recommended for severely obese patients who have not lost weight using behavioral and pharmacological treatments. The surgery generally involves reducing the size of the stomach to increase early satiety by disrupting the release of ghrelin from the stomach, or decreasing the length of bowel through which food may be absorbed. Dental appliances such as conventional jaw wiring and orthodontic wiring keep the jaw closed for a period of time, preventing the ingestion of solid food, and are used for weight loss purposes. Tobacco smoking is associated with appetite suppression, but cannot be recommended for weight loss.